Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. From this video, we will start building our RecyclerView. And as I told you, we will get the RecyclerView data from APIs. And I have created two mock APIs for our project. And I have created it using mockapi.io. So this is my API URL. And basically I have two APIs. One will give me the list of movies, as you can see here, and one API will give me the list of directors like this. So these two APIs we will use to fetch data for our RecyclerView. Now I have created this API using mockapi.io, and in future, sometimes if the API is not working, then in that case, you need to build your own API, and you can use any tool for making your own dummy APIs. Now let's come back to our project. To map the JSON response that I am getting from the API, I have created some classes here. As you can see, I have movie and I have director. And all these classes are inside my sealed class, that is home recycler view item. Now this class is for my recycler view item, and I will pass a list of recycler view item to my recycler view adapter that we will create. And inside this sealed class, we have three different classes. The two is to get JSON information, and one is for the title view type that I showed you in the last video, and we will hard code the information for this title class. So basically you can create as many classes as you need to build your complex recycler view or complex list for your application. So we have home recycler view item ready, and I also have defined the API calls inside my API interface. So I have two APIs, movies and directors, and both the APIs will give me a list. So first I have list of home recycler view item dot movie, and then list of home recycler view item dot director. Now I will hit these APIs to get the movies and directors list. Now after this, first we will create a view holder for our recycler view. And if you go to activity underscore main dot XML, you will see the recycler view is already created here. As you can see here, I have a recycler view inside my activity underscore main.xml, and I also have a progress bar because we are getting the data from API, so we need to display a progress bar while we are fetching the data from API. So this is about activity underscore main.xml. I also have three different items for my recycler view. I have item director, as you can see here. Then I have item movie, as you can see here. And then I have item title. So I have three different view types for my recycler view. Now I will use these view types to build my view holder for the recycler view adapter. And to do this, again, I will create a sealed class. So inside my UI package, I am creating, let's say I will create home recycler view holder. So this is my view holder for my home recycler view that we have inside this activity underscore main.xml. Now I will make this class as sealed class because we have multiple view types and I want the compiler to know the available view types. So in this kind of situation where you want to make strict class hierarchies, you can use sealed classes. If you don't know about sealed classes, then I will leave the link in the description where you can learn more about sealed classes. So this is my sealed class home recycler view holder. And as we want to create a recycler view holder, we need to extend or inherit recycler view dot view holder like this. Now the constructor of the view holder class expects a view. So we will pass a view to our home recycler view holder. Now I am going to use view binding in this project, and that is why to home recycler view holder I will pass binding, and the type will be view binding. And to the view holder constructor, we need to pass a view, and we can get the view from this binding instance. So here I will write binding.root, and this root will return the view that we will pass to this home recycler view holder. Now inside the seal class, we will define individual view types or view holders for our recycler view adapter. And to each view holder, we will extend or inherit this home recycler view holder. So in our recycler view, we have three view types: for title, for movie, and for director. So here inside the sealed class, we will create three different classes. So first we will create class, let's say title view holder, and this class will extend home recycler view holder. Now to this class, we need to pass a binding, and the binding that we have for title view holder is we have item title binding. So here we can write private val binding of type item title binding. Because we are using view binding, so the compiler generates all the view binding classes, and this class is for this layout file, that is item underscore title. Now we will pass this binding to the home recycler view holder constructor. So we will pass the binding here, and now we have the title view holder ready. Now inside the title view holder, we will define a function, and I will define fun bind. And to this bind function, we will pass our title instance. So here we can pass title, and it is an instance of home recycler view item dot title. That's it. Now what we will do is we will bind the values inside this bind function, and to bind the values, we already have the binding instance here. So we will use binding dot text view title dot text equals to title dot title, like this. And if you go to text view title, then it is here. So let's go back to home recycler view holder, and here we used this text view title to set the title of the movie. And if we go to item title binding again, then we have a view all here, and we do not need to set any data for this view because it is a hard-coded thing, and we just need to handle a click listener to this text view. But we will do it later, because right now I am not writing any code for handling clicks. We will do it in coming videos. In this video, we will just finish this home recycler view holder. So we have our title view holder ready, and the same way we will define director view holder and movie view holder. So I will copy the same class, and I will write movie view holder. And for the binding, I will use item movie binding, and rest of the things are same. Inside the bind function, I will load image from the URL to the image view that we have inside this item movie binding. So you can see I have just an image view for this item movie, and we need to load the image, and I am getting the image URL from the API. And I already created an extension function to load images using URL, and to load image I'm using Fresco library here. So let's go back to home recycler view holder, and here I will write binding dot image view movie dot load image, and I will pass we have written title here. I will change it to movie, and here also we need to change it to movie, and from movie I will get thumbnail. So I will load the thumbnail inside the image view. Now the same way I will create one more class for director. So this time I will name it director view holder. And for the binding, we will use item director binding. And here we will write director, and we will use the class director. And this time we will use binding image view director dot load image, and we will get the director image from director dot avatar. Now we will use binding dot text view name dot text equals to director dot name. And the same way we will use binding dot text view movies. This is the count of the movie for a particular director, as you have seen in the final output. So we will write dot text equals to, and for the text we just need the movie count, that is a dynamic value, and rest of the string is an hard-coded value. So if you go to values folder, then I have also defined some strings here. As you can see, I have total movies here. And whenever you want to pass dynamic values to your string resource files, you can write percentage and then parameter number and then dollar and the data type. Now I can pass a dynamic value while using this string. So I will use this string to show movies count. So here I will write, I basically need to get the context, and I can get the context using this binding. So I will write binding dot text view movies or any text view, and then from the view I will get the context. And with the help of context, I will call the getString function to get the string that I have inside my strings.xml file. And here I will write r.string. We need to import r. And then I will get here total movies like this. And for the dynamic parameter, I will pass director.movieCount like this. So we have created bind function for all the view holders, and we just have three view holders for our recycler view. Now we can use this view holder for our recycler view adapter, but the adapter we will create in the next video. So thanks for watching, everyone. In case you have any problem or confusion, you can leave your comments below. Thanks for watching. This is Bilal Khan, now signing off.